Thank you.
Cherry and amaretto tarts. Okay, very simple.
I love you, Gina.
Okay, so what are we doing here?
I don't know.
Shortcrust pastry. Mm-hmm. You can buy the one already made. Mm-hmm. I like to make my own one. And the way I do it, I put icing sugar in it. Okay? Now, the secret, I'm not going to show you because this is going to take a long time. The secret is very simple. Plain flour, butter needs to be cold, icing sugar. You start to mix together. The secret is to make sure you don't knead the dough for a long time.
Right.
The more you knead the dough, the more elastic it becomes, the gluten comes out of the flour. You want it to knead as least as possible.
Okay.
What does the icing sugar do when you put
it? It caramelized the crust. So what's happening? It makes the crust hard by putting sugar. You know, sugar caramelized, so it makes it hard. So when we're going to put the filling now inside, it's not going to get all soggy.
Right.
Okay? Now, obviously, once we roll it, we put in a pastry case. Mm-hmm. The oven, 200 degrees. So we cook the first 12 minutes at 200 degrees, and we cook it blind, okay? Mm-hmm. And blind with the beans. Mm-hmm. Not blind like Stevie Wonder. You know, blind like the beans. So then we take the beans off, and then we do the last 5 minutes just the way it should be.
Yeah.
We take it out and job is done. Now, for the filling, you may ask yourself what's happening. Eggs, okay? In there, we put icing sugar. Very simple. Then ground almonds. Ground almonds is important. Philip, are you with me?
Absolutely fine.
Ground almonds is important because it gives you that kind of a marzipan texture.
Yeah.
Then we're going to put a little meal, a marzipan.
I thought you said a massive pan.
Massive pan.
Oh, right. No, I'm back with you. Massive pan. Okay.
Amaretto liqueur goes in there because it's the flavour of Christmas. You can put orange liqueurs or other stuff, but I think amaretto works really well. Mm-hmm. Now, Philip, what I got there? I know that you're a huge fan of clotted cream.
I am.
Okay, have you ever done clotted cream with crushed amaretto?
No.
Ooh.
Okay, crushed amaretto in there. Okay, just pick them up and crush them in there.
Oh, okay.
One by one and fold it in.
Do I just eat it?
You can crush it. No, you just mix it. Rochelle, you can crush it for him.
Oh.
Now, what are you doing? Look at the texture that I'm getting here.
I like this.
It's like a stress ball.
Look at that. Can you see the texture I'm getting here?
Yeah.
Very easy. You just whip everything
up. Do you want all of these in?
All of it, yeah. Yeah. That's actually is a nice thing to do instead of clotted cream sometimes. Can be slightly too overpowered, too creamy.
Right.
So I like to have a crunch in it.
Yeah, there's a lot of crunch in there.
Guys, look what I'm doing. I'm putting the mixture in. If you're at home and you think, that is a small amount of mixture for the tart. No. Remember, this is going to rise a little, okay? Once we've done that, cherries. You can use pitted cherries in a tin. Or otherwise, go for the fresh one. All right, just like that. Just put them around and push them in.
The fake
Which
cherries.
One?
I don't like those.
The glacé ones.
Oh.
Don't like those?
You don't like the glacé
one? That turns me off every dessert if they're in there. Real cherries, I love.
You know, the glacé one wouldn't work here because they would completely mash up.
Right, okay.
Now, 170 degrees, okay? 50 minutes you have to cook this one. Let me give you a tip, though. After 20 minutes, take a little bit of foil and just do that. Go on the edges of the dish. Like that.
Okay.
The reason why, because the edges, they always get burned after 50 minutes.
Yeah.
All right? So, once you've done that, this goes in the oven. Don't worry, I got one that I prepared earlier. There you go.
Look at this.
This is what it looks like. Philip, can I have the plates? So, this is what it looks like after. Guys, you're going to like this. Philip, you're going to like this.
Tell me.
Okay, ready? Okay, everybody at home, look what I found. So, you put in there. Then you twist the end, and
that is good.
Yeah, you like stuff like that. I knew you would like it. That's why I showed it to you. Look.
Where did you find that?
I don't know. Julia gave it to me. Julia, where did we find this one? The bowl that shakes.
Where? Amazon.
Amazon.
Well, that's very helpful. Thank you.
That's really good.
Can you believe that? The one chance she had to shine on this.
Julia will not appear on television. She can't bear it.
But
we got a voice on. That's good.
That's brilliant.
How cool is that?
That's a very good idea.
And then you put it there. Philip, can you put a dollop of that?
Where would you like it? On the side or on top?
On the side. On the side, on the top, whatever you want. You know me, my style of cook, whatever you fancy.
God.
This we're going to put in here.
That's
That's I know a bit that too much, is it?
It wasn't very neat. I know, it dropped off. I can only apologise.
Ah, OK.
We don't...
No, we're going to eat at the table. Why, you want to eat here
okay.
now?
Oh, no, we won't eat here. We'll do it at the table. You're right.
All right, the other thing I wanted to show everybody is that's what we do in Italy as well. Often we tend to buy, especially at Christmas time, fruits that should not be around.
Yeah.
I.e. strawberries, OK? How do we make them nicer? What I do? I do two different chocolate, very plain dark chocolate, plain white chocolate. Mm-hmm. I dip them in, and then some of them with crushed hazelnuts.
Yeah.
I put them on top. Some of them with crushed amaretti, like we just did. Some of them with a little bit of chili flakes.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Okay.
I like that.
Some of them with chopped mint.
Yeah.
And this is the hooray. How do you say
what? Hooray.
Array.
The array
of selection that you
Thank
can
you.
Do.
There's so much down on that table. We may as well have a taste of this here.
Don't forget to flog my book.
Oh yeah.
Tell us about your book.
Because
you completely forgot it.
I have not.
The book is on the left.
I've got it
still
planned.
Standing there. You
I've
got it planned.
Got it planned.
Okay. Right. Remember,
watch,
I'm not
just watch what I had planned. Okay.
Okay?
Right. There's nothing subtle
so
about
rude.
You at all.
Okay. How is he?
That is beautiful.
People are wondering, if you wanted the recipe, where do you get the recipe? That's what people are wondering.
On the app. On the app. Everybody knows it's on the app. Or they could get it out of your book.
Oh, funny you mentioned that, because it's...
Walk to the table and sit down. And as we walk past the table...
Sorry, I thought you forgot.
Here's Gino's book on the top already.
Very nice.
Lovely.
Yeah, very good.
We've got one of your films on the show tomorrow as well.
All right, yeah. Yeah, thank you very much.
There you go.
Do have a seat, everyone.
Please, good. Now, in Italy, everybody always say to me, you know, how many courses... Is it true that you guys eat a lot of food? This is only a quarter of what we would eat in Italy.
If you look at this table here and have a look, if there's anything you like, all the details of how to make it are on the app.
So if you'd like to,
because this is your last show before Christmas.
Is this mine?
This is your present.
Your Christmas present.
There
we go.
Aldo Zilli's book.
So we've got Aldo Zilli's book, got some pasta sauce, got some salad cream. Very important.
Very important sauce.
There you go. You've got a.
What is that?
Yeah, it's a little,
there you go.
Little sweatshirt for you there.
Very nice. How very thoughtful. This is.
Merry Christmas.
There you go. Guess which present was from me?